factor affecting on enzyme activity. Next point of our factor affecting on enzyme activity. As we know, the enzymes are the biocatalyst. So always biological substance which is made up of by protein that are affected with various factors like enzyme concentration, substrate concentration, pH, temperature, then inhibitors. These all are the factors which are affected on the enzymes, because enzyme is a biocatalyst, it is made up of by protein. जैसे हमारे बॉडी को भी टेम्परेचर की इफेक्ट होती है, पीएच की इफेक्ट होती है ना? तो वैसे ही अगर हम ज्यादा खा लेते हैं तो भी प्रॉब्लम, कम खाते हैं तो भी प्रॉब्लम, तो वैसे एंजाइम को भी पर्टिकुलर चीज पर्टिकुलर अमाउंट में ही चाहिए. जैसे पीएच है तो जो एंजाइम एसिडिक पीएच में काम करता है वो बेसिक पीएच में काम नहीं करेगा, और जो एंजाइम्स बेसिक पीएच में काम करता है वो एसिडिक पीएच में काम नहीं करेगा, क्योंकि वो उसका वर्क जोन जो है वो बेसिक पर्टिकुलर पीएच, जैसे 8 पीएच पे काम करता है तो वो 8 पीएच पे मैक्सिमम एक्टिविटी देगा, पर जब वो उसको 7 पीएच कर दिया या 9 पीएच कर दिया वो एक्टिविटी देगा, बट जो 8 पीएच जितनी एक्टिविटी थी उतनी नहीं देगा. तो ऐसे टेम्परेचर, कोई एंजाइम्स अपना बॉडी का टेम्परेचर 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस, दैट मीन्स वी बिलीव दैट ऑल एंजाइम वर्क ऑन 37 डिग्री सेल्सियस, बट इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. बहुत सारे ऐसे भी एंजाइम होते हैं जो क्या करते हैं, जो एंजाइम्स 37 पे वर्क करेंगे, पर कभी ऐसा होता है कि वो 40 पे भी ऑप्टिमम होते हैं, कभी 32 पे भी ऑप्टिमम होते हैं. तो ये सारी चीजें अफेक्ट होती है क्योंकि एंजाइम्स इज अ बायोकैटालिस्ट. तो सबस्ट्रेट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन मतलब क्या, कि जैसे कोई सबस्ट्रेट हम डाल रहे हैं, एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ, ग्लूकोज प्लस हेक्सोकाइनेज, हेक्सोकाइनेज इज एंजाइम्स एंड ग्लूकोज इज अ सबस्ट्रेट, ओके. तो अगर ग्लूकोज का इतना ज्यादा मैं कॉन्सेंट्रेशन कर दूंगा और एंजाइम बहुत कम होंगे, तो क्या आप समझ पाते हो कि एंजाइम्स उसके साथ बाइंड हो पाएंगे? नहीं, क्योंकि एक नेबरिंग इफेक्ट होती है. नेबरिंग इफेक्ट मतलब क्या, कि बहुत सारे सबस्ट्रेट होने से एंजाइम्स, जैसे आप जानते होंगे कि भीड़ बहुत होती है और जाने की जगह एक होती है, तो धक्का मुक्की बहुत होती है और कोई निकल पाता है कोई निकल नहीं पाता है. तो वैसे ही होगा, कोई सब्सट्रेट एंजाइम के साथ बाइंड होगा तो एक्टिविटी बहुत स्लो होगी, इवन दो सब्सट्रेट इज वेरी हाई, अंडरस्टूड. तो वैसे ही पीएच, जैसे पीएच पर्टिकुलर पीएच पे अगर काम करते हैं कोई एंजाइम्स, तो फिर वो अगर उससे कम होगा या उससे ज्यादा पीएच होगी, वो या तो कम काम करेगा या तो उतनी एक्टिविटी नहीं लेगा. वैसे ही इनहिबिटर, हमने लास्ट लेक्चर में डिस्कस किया था, इनहिबिटर इज अ टू टाइप, आइदर कॉम्पिटिटिव इनहिबिटर और नॉन कॉम्पिटिटिव इनहिबिटर. पर उसका काम क्या है, इट इनहिबिट द एंजाइम एक्टिविटी. तो ऑल द फैक्टर्स इज अफेक्टेड ऑन एंजाइम एक्टिविटी. दिस इज अ सबस्ट्रेट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, नॉन एंजाइमेटिक रिएक्शन. यू कैन सी, अगर सबस्ट्रेट हम डालते हैं तो ग्रेजुअली धीरे 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 एंजाइम एक्टिविटी बढ़, मतलब नॉन एंजाइमेटिक रिएक्शन है, तो आप देख रहे हो कि सबस्ट्रेट जैसे बढ़ रहा है वैसे ही क्या हो रहा है, कोई प्रोडक्ट बन रही है. जो नॉर्मली हम नॉर्मल स्टैंडर्ड कोई पाथवे रन करते हैं, स्टैंडर्ड जैसे डेंसा प्रैक्टिकल करते हैं, तो उसमें क्या कहते हैं, हम ग्लूकोज का कॉन्सेंट्रेशन धीरे धीरे बढ़ा रहे, तो वैसे ही लीनियर ग्राफ आता है, ओके. मतलब उसका वेलोसिटी बढ़ती जाती है, उसका रिएक्शन बढ़ता जाता है. तो इंक्रीज इन वेलोसिटी इज अ प्रोपोर्शनल टू द सबस्ट्रेट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. ये नॉर्मली हमको बताया गया है कि जैसे जैसे इंक्रीज सबस्ट्रेट होता जाएगा वेलोसिटी बढ़ती जाएगी. पर इन द केस ऑफ एंजाइम्स, दिस इज एंजाइम रिएक्शन. यू कैन सी इन द पर्टिकुलर सबस्ट्रेट कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, आप देख रहे हो ना पहले के ग्राफ में क्या था, कि भाई एंजाइम एक्टिविटी जो थी वहां नहीं थी, एंजाइम नहीं था. तो हम डेंसा ग्राफ को अगर कंपेयर करते तो 0.1 ml, 0.2 ml, 0.3 ml, पॉइंट, प्लीज अपना माइक प्लीज म्यूट कर देना. तो जैसे ही एंजाइम एक्टिविटी जैसे ही बढ़ती जा रही, सॉरी सबस्ट्रेट बढ़ता जा रहा है, आप देख रहे होंगे कि ओडी बढ़ती है और आपका ग्राफ लीनियर आता है ना, वेलोसिटी बढ़ती है. पर इन द केस ऑफ एंजाइम, अगर एंजाइम अवेलेबल है और प्रोडक्ट कन्वर्जन हो रही है विद द हेल्प ऑफ सबस्ट्रेट, देन यू कैन सी gradually increase the activity, but at particular point, maximum velocity is nearby we achieve, and then after, even though we increase the substrate, the activity almost similar. So that shows the enzyme substrate relationship. A particular concentration of enzymes and particular concentration of substrate, that gives a very good activity. If the substrate is low or high, it is affected the activity. Even after the maximum velocity nearby, if we increase the substrate, then also enzyme cannot accelerate the reactions. So this is the main point of enzyme. So enzyme is affected with substrate concentration, and is the most important things. Faster reaction, but it reach a saturation point. When all the enzyme molecule are occupied with the substrate, it gives a maximum activity. And then, even though substrate is high, but enzyme cannot accelerate the reactions. So this is our main important. Once it achieve the Vmax, enzymes when achieve the Vmax, then it gives the maximum activity. Once Vmax, maximum velocity is achieved, even though adding the substrate, it cannot alter the reactions. It cannot increase the reactions. So you can see next effect. In the case of pH, if pH is increase or decrease in particular enzyme, suppose example yahan pe diya hai, pepsin. You all are know pepsin is a present in the stomach, right? And it is a acidic enzymes. So you see over here, it work in nearby 1.8 pH, that is optimum pH, where it is gives a maximum velocity. If the pH is increased, you can see the red line decrease the activity. And ultimately in the basic pH, enzyme activity is almost stopped. Vice versa, if we see the trypsin, it is a present in intestine, so it is a work in alkaline pH. So if you see the acidic, if the environment is acidic, then the activity is not much more. But when the environment is nearby neutral, it starts the activity. And near the basic, approximately 7.8 to 8.2 pH, it gives the maximum activity. So the trypsin work in a basic pH and pepsin work in a acidic pH. If we alter the pH in the medium, then pepsin and trypsin cannot work. That means optimum pH is required. Why the pH is affected? Because extreme pH level produce a denaturation. We see in first lecture, protein denaturation and renaturation. So here, if we provide high pH, then it denaturation. The structure of enzyme is changed, the active site is destroyed, and the substrate molecule will not longer fit in it. At pH value slightly different from the enzyme's optimum value, small changes in the change of the enzyme and its substrate molecule will occur and it can bind, but it not gives the maximum activity. This change in ionization will affect the binding of substrate with the capacity of enzyme substrate binding. The temperature Q10, mind well, it may be asked in the exams, what is Q10? Q10 is the quotient 10. Quotient 10 is a every 10 degree temperature increase the reaction. That is the law of Q10. For chemical reaction, every time 2 to 3, the rate of reaction is double or triplate with every 10 degree rise the temperature. But in the case of enzyme, it is not like this. It not follow these rules. Enzyme controls the reaction, follow this rule as they are chemical reactions. But in high temperature, enzyme become denatured. Suppose one enzyme work in 30 degree Celsius. So according to Q10 law, what happen? If we increase a 40 degree temperature, then reaction will be double or product will be double. But it is not like this because enzyme is affected at the high degree, high temperature. So if high temperature is provided, protein may denature or alter the structure. The optimum temperature for enzyme control reaction will be balanced between Q10 and denaturation. Mind well, optimum temperature, jaise 30 and 40, humne variation kiya 30 se 40 degree mein, par aisa nahi hai ki 40 degree pe maximum activity dega. We have to find out Q10 ke beech mein koi aisa point hoga, that is the our maximum temperature, optimum temperature. And optimum temperature gives the optimum product. You can see over here, every 10 degree we see 30 and 40 degree Celsius. In between that, there is a peak, high peak, and it shows the maximum or optimum temperature. And above that, denaturation will be start. So in between particular Q10, you may find the optimum temperature. So temperature is also affected. For most enzymes, optimum temperature is about 30 degrees Celsius. Many are work in lower cold water fish that die at 30 degree because their enzyme denature. At few bacteria have temperature can withstand every high temperature up to 100 degrees Celsius. Most of enzyme, however, are fully denature at 30 degrees Celsius. That means most of enzymes, if it is an increase at 30 degrees Celsius, then it denature. So any organism is die due to denaturation of enzyme at high temperature. Inhibitor are chemicals and that reduce the rate of enzyme reactions. They are usually specific. They work at low concentration. They block the enzyme, but they do not usually destroy it. Many drugs and poison are inhibitor of enzymes in the nervous system. Inhibition is a two type, irreversible inhibition and reversible inhibition. Irreversible inhibition, that means once the inhibitor are bind with the enzymes, enzyme cannot activate. Combined with the functional group of amino acid in the active sites irreversibly, that means enzyme, if it is a inhibitor is bind, then it cannot work further. So that is called irreversible. For example, nerves gases and pesticide containing organophosphorus combined with the serine residue of the enzyme acetylcholine esterase, then it permanently block the transmission of impulse and ultimately we die because the nervous system is blocked with the help of this poison. Now gases, pesticides containing organophosphorus. So serine residue, which is a present at active sites, it block the active sites of acetylcholine esterase, and that's why it is an irreversible inhibitor. Reversible inhibitor, that means it can be a reverse. That means once inhibitor is bind with the enzymes, at temporary time, it can be enzyme can be cannot work. It is inhibited. But at particular condition, inhibitor remove and enzyme start the work. So that is called the reversible inhibitor. This can be wash out the solution of the enzyme by dialysis and it can be again work. So in the case of reversible, again two type, competitive and non-competitive. Competitive, this compete with the substrate molecule for the active sites. Competitor molecules are the structural analogous of the substrate. So the substrate and inhibitor structure almost similar, and that's why it can bind with the enzymes active sites. If the substrate is bind, then ES complex is formed and product is formed. But if the I is bind, that is the inhibitor, then enzyme is blocked, EI complex is formed, that is an enzyme inhibitor complex is formed, and it cannot produce the product. So ultimately it slows the reactions. Product is also formed, very low number, and gradually the enzyme is inhibitor. This inhibitor reaction is proportional to the its concentration. If the inhibitor concentration is high, then enzyme block. Resemble the substrate structure, that's why it can easily bind with the substrate. This is the example, succinate convert into fumarate, and this is a succinate dehydrogenase. You can see this is a structures, sorry, normal reactions. If the inhibitor is bind, look, malonate, it is a malonate, very similar with the structures. And if it is a bind with the succinate dehydrogenase, then it cannot work. It is a structural analogous, that's why. Competitor, non-competitive inhibitions, there are not influenced by the concentration of substrate. It inhibit by binding irreversibly to the enzyme, but not at the active sites. Non-competitive, that means what? Enzymes substrate complex is formed, but inhibitor bind with other sites so that it cannot allow the reactions and product is not formed. They are not influenced by the substrate concentration. It bind the irreversible to enzyme, but not at the active sites. For example, cyanide combined with the iron in the enzyme cytochrome oxidase, and this block the all activity of the our mitochondria and other, so we die. Heavy metals like Ag, Hg combined with the SH group of the amino acids which is present in enzyme, and it is a completely bind and it can be a loss the enzymes. This can be a removed by using the chelating agent using EDTA. So some metal can be removed, although it is a irreversible, but we can add certain chelate agent. So according to their attraction, it can bind with the EDTA molecules and it is a release with the from the enzymes, and enzyme can again work. Application of inhibitor, you can see negative feedback. With the help of inhibitor, every biochemical reaction was studied. Inhibitor is added, so enzyme is blocked, and we can find, or scientists find, the product and substrate. So it is a useful for the research. Negative feedback end product or end product inhibition, we can find out with the help of inhibitor. Poison, snake bite, plant alkaloids, and now gas is a poison. So it is an inhibitor, and it is an application for the certain drugs manufacturing, medicines, antibiotics, sulfonylamides, sedatives, and stimulants. This is again a purpose of medicines. So some useful as a poison, some useful as a medicine, some useful for the research. So you can see in the enzyme also useful in the medicines. Enzyme glucose oxidase plus peroxidase, it plus blue dye on the this stick to detect the glucose in urine. This is a normal functions. Normal, you can see the diabetic how glucose peroxidase is work. Glucose oxidase react and it form hydrogen peroxide. Peroxide is work and blue color is converted into green and brown. So dye change according to amount of glucose. It is a useful for the diabetic patient. Another application, you can see animal feed for the enzyme fermentations, centrifugation removal cell, culture suspension and liquid preparation to animal feed in the market. You might be know the waste material of plant debris and other. So if we add the culture or enzymes, then it can break down and it is a convert into simple forms. Either we can go for liquid preparation or solid preparation, and this is used as an animal feed. Analytical for enzyme application, fermentations, centrifugation to the removal of cell, culture supernatant present where it is a protein is present, protein is fraction, precipitation and fraction is carried out. After the 1-2 step of purification, semi-purified protein is there. And that protein is useful for the determination of various activities, various application. It is used like antibody detection of immobilized enzyme is useful for the detection of pregnancy or any other kit formations. Okay, this is a therapeutic proteins. Therapeutic proteins, that is a again same principle. Fermentation is carried out, removal of the medium, cell pellets is there, cell lysis, intracellular fraction we are separated. Protein separation, 3-4 times the separation technique, and homogeneous protein is available, and that protein either useful for the medicine purpose. So likewise, this is a applications fungal enzymes, amylase, the EC number 3.2.1.1. The source of amylase is Aspergillus, is a name of organism, locations and the application. Banking, extracellular, location that means extracellular or intracellular. Catalase enzyme, 1.11.1.6, Aspergillus again, and intracellular, it is useful for the food making. Like cellulase enzyme, 3.2.1.4, trichoderma, it is again fungi, extracellular, and it is useful for the waste. Dextranase, 3.2.1.11, penicillium, extracellulase, food. So these are the different example of fungal enzymes. So you easily understand application of enzyme, where it is applied, and according to that you can use. This is a bacterial enzymes, alpha enzyme, bacillus, extracellular, starch degradation. Beta amylase, bacillus again, starch degradation. Asparaginase, Escherichia coli, for the health, intracellular. Glucose isomerase, bacillus, intracellular, fructose syrup. Penicillin amidase, bacillus, intracellular, pharmaceutical. So lot of enzyme is available which is having the applications. Amylase, hydrolysis of starch, glucose is formed, and it is mostly readily available for the plant polysaccharides. Production of sweetener, from the start, like maltose or glucose syrup, further transformation to high fructose syrup with a glucose isomer. Starch hydrolyzate used as additive in the manufacturing of candy, baked goods, canned food, foods and frozen foods. So these are the application of amylase. Amylase, protease and lipase is a tremendously used in the industrial application. Protease, it is used in detergent industry. Glucose isomerase, D-glucose, keto isomerase cause the isomerization of glucose to fructose. It is irreversible. The reactions of glucose and fructose depend on the enzyme and reaction condition. High fructose corn syrup is made by the these enzymes. Chymosin is a site-specific proteolytic enzyme, and it is a detached hydrophilic tail of the K caseins, resulting in the coagulation and curdling. Calf chymosin, prochymosin clone the expression in E. coli first genetically enzymes. Engineered application is also used, genetic engineer. Another, that is aspartic acid and phenylalanine are synthesized into aspartame, the artificial sweetener through the enzyme thermolysin. Aspartame is a non-nutritive sweetener of diet, soft drinks and other food sold as a low calorie or sugar free product. So this is the application of enzyme. You see, what is the application? Aspartame is a sweetening agent which is artificial formed by the enzymes, and it is a useful for the diabetic. Microbial enzyme and their application. You can see over here, amylase, that is a fungi, bacteria. You can see lot of application. Protease, invertase, glucose oxidase, pectinase, rhenane, lipase, lactase, and DNA polymerase. Lot of application. You can see DNA polymerase is used in a PCR. That is a big application in all the fields.